customize these roles and permissions as well. So as a part of you know test planning process in testing activity, so RQM allows you to define various things in a test planning. You can define your business and test objectives. So as you are aware of that, for every release you will be having some kind of test objectives, like okay, my product should be not more than you know 5 small defects. You know, those defects should not affect your you know business process. So you are having certain goals for each particular release. You can define those goals as a part of your test planning, and also you can establish a review process. So you have a test plan in place and you want to get it reviewed by someone, maybe who is a product manager or your client. Then you can you know send this test plan as a part of review process using RQM, and you can manage you know project requirements and test cases, and you can establish interdependencies, basically kind of traceability. Okay, you know as you know day progresses, your requirement gets may get changed, your requirements get changed, your test cases you know of course obviously must be changed. So in that case, you should have some kind of interdependencies between these two for making any kind of changes. And you can estimate your efforts, what is the effort involved for execution of your test plan, and also you can have a schedule, okay, when it is getting executed, and also what is the effort involved in executing this test plan. And also you can list a set of test environments. Test environments means it can be combination of your both hardware and software environments. You can generate your test configurations to run this test plan. So simple scenario would be, okay, if you are testing your product in a different you know environments, for example, if you want to test it in both Windows and Linux environments, you can always generate test configurations, and you can execute the in you know this test plan in a different platforms. And it also allows you to create a snapshots of the test plan. So the details about this snapshot will be discussed in the later part. And it also allows you to define your quality goals. And you have your entry criteria. You can define your exit criteria of the test plan. Okay. Entry, for example, entrance criteria. What would be, you would have an entry criteria for any test plan is before you start your execution, test execution, so you want to make sure that okay, my entry criteria should be, you know, suppose for this release you had planned, you know, 30 defects to be resolved for this release, so you should make sure that okay, all the 30 defects should be resolved by any developer. That is your entry criteria. So exit criteria would be, for example, after your testing phase is completed, I have 30 defects resolved, and you you know at least in the testing phase it, the results should come out as okay, 28 defects have been resolved. Still there are some issues with the 2 defects. So that can be an exit criteria or exit criteria. So basically, I'm trying to say is, entry criteria and exit criteria you can define based on your requirements and how you plan to deliver your product. And create and manage test cases. Of course, as a test plan, what are the different test cases we will be covering for this particular test plan? You can also have the test case as a part of your test plan. And also, you can view the execution progress, overall execution progress. Of course, there may be different team members who are executing different test cases in your team. So as a whole, what is the execution progress of test plan also we can view. So in the next slide, this is a sample screenshot of RQM menu, where you know this is a sample screenshot is open for creation of test plan. As you can see, there are different sections over here. All these sections we have already you know discussed. This is the execution progress. You can always see what is the execution progress, like What is the what was the total hours and what was the next estimated hours spent, and also progress is what are the percentage, what was the, what is the total goal and what is the progress so far. You can see these are different sections, and also you can customize these sections. You can have your own sections by using manage sections here. You have a snapshots. We have history of this artifact. History means it can have if somebody has changed this test plan for some time, then it records the history. Okay, who has changed, what has been changed, etc. It will also record. So snapshot, as I said, okay, it will be discussed in the later stage of this presentation. So now we have seen that very high level.